Today we're going to show you how to make DNA libraries using the AnyBNext Ultra 2 DNA Library Prep Kit for Illumina. Before you begin, you'll want to make sure that you have available all of the required reagents and equipment that are not included in the kit. Your DNA should be fragmented to the size range suitable for your sample and sequencing requirements. This can be done using either mechanical methods or enzymatic methods. The volume of your sample should be adjusted to 50 microliters, and this should contain 500 picograms to 1 microgram of fragmented DNA. Although the Ultra 2 kit can be used with very low input amounts, we recommend using higher amounts if available to minimize the number of PCR cycles required. When working with the reagents included in the kit, it's important to ensure that they are well mixed before use. The first steps in library construction are end repair and DA tailing. In this step, the input DNA is blunted and phosphorylated, and an A is added to the 3' end of each fragment. In the Ultra 2 workflow, these two steps are combined. You will be using the nPrep enzyme mix and the nPrep reaction buffer, which are in the green capped vials. For each library, add 3 microliters of the nPrep enzyme mix and 7 microliters of the nPrep reaction buffer to your 50 microliter fragmented DNA sample. Mix well by pipetting up and down 10 times. Incubate this in a thermocycler at 20 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes, followed by 65 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes, then hold at 4 degrees Celsius. In this step, adapters with a single T overhang are ligated to the N-repaired DA-tailed fragments. If you started with less than 100 nanograms of input DNA, we recommend using lower amounts of adapter to reduce the risk of adapter dimer formation. The reagents used in this step are the Ultra 2 Ligation Master Mix, the Ligation Enhancer, and the adapter, which are in the red capped vials. Note that the Ultra 2 Ligation Master Mix is very viscous, so it is important to pipette slowly to ensure you are getting the desired volume. The Ultra 2 Ligation Master Mix and Ligation Enhancer can be combined ahead of time and stored at 4 degrees Celsius and will be stable for at least 8 hours. Add the Ultra 2 Ligation Master Mix, Ligation Enhancer, and adapter to the nPrep reaction and mix well. We recommend setting a 100 or 200 microliter pipette to 80 microliters and then pipetting up and down at least 10 times. A quick spin will collect all liquid from the sides of the tube. Incubate at 20 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes in a thermocycler with the heated lid turned off. If you are using the AnyBNext adapter, add 3 microliters of user enzyme and mix. Incubate at 37 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes with the heated lid set to at least 47 degrees Celsius. If necessary, samples may now be stored at minus 20 degrees Celsius overnight. Size selection enriches for molecules that were sheared to the desired size and have an adapter ligated to each end. Size selection is accomplished using magnetic beads. There are 2 rounds of selection. The first removes DNA fragments larger than the desired size, and the second removes DNA fragments smaller than the desired size. This is accomplished using specific ratios of the bead solution to total volume, and the volume of beads required varies depending on the desired fragment size. Magnetic beads should be used at room temperature and they should be vortexed before use. For the first round of size selection, add vortexed beads to the reaction and mix well by pipetting up and down at least 10 times. Incubate for 5 minutes at room temperature, then place the reaction into the magnetic field. After approximately 5 minutes, the beads should have separated from the supernatant. carefully remove the supernatant and avoid disturbing the pellet. Vertical bar magnets pull the beads to one side of the tube or well, and the supernatant can be removed by placing the pipette tip on the opposite side of the tube or well from the magnet. Plates with circular magnets pull the beads uniformly to the walls of the tube or well, so the supernatant can be removed by pipetting straight down into the bottom of the tube or well, being careful not to touch the sides. In this first round of size selection, the unwanted large fragments are bound to the beads and the desired DNA is in the supernatant. Retain the supernatant. For the second round of size selection, add new magnetic beads. Incubate for 5 minutes. Expose to a magnetic field and remove the supernatant. Discard the supernatant as the desired DNA is bound to the beads in the pellet. Wash the beads with 200 microliters of 80% ethanol while they are in the magnetic field. Incubate for 30 seconds at room temperature and then remove the ethanol. Repeat this wash step once. Allow the beads to air dry while the beads are in the magnetic field, but avoid over drying the pellet. Remove the tube or plate containing the dried bead pellet from the magnet and elute the library from the beads by adding 17 microliters of tris hydrochloride or 0.1x TE buffer, followed by mixing well by pipetting up and down or vortexing. A quick spin may be required to collect the liquid to the bottom of the tube or plate. Incubate for an additional 2 minutes at room temperature. Return the sample to the magnet for 5 minutes or until the sample clears and remove 15 microliters of the supernatant. Add this 15 microliters to a fresh PCR tube for library amplification. The final step of library preparation is library amplification by PCR. This step not only increases the amount of library, but also selects for molecules that have an adapter ligated to each end. For multiplexed libraries, indices or barcodes can be introduced at this step if the NEB-NEXT adapter and primers are used. To each sample, add the universal PCR primer, an index primer, and the Ultra 2 Q5 Master Mix, which are in the blue capped vials. Mix thoroughly as shown previously. The number of PCR cycles will vary and is determined by the original amount of input DNA. This step also uses magnetic beads, but this time there is a single step, after which the desired DNA, the library, is bound to the beads. Don't discard the beads. Add 45 microliters of vortexed magnetic beads to the reaction and mix well by pipetting up and down at least 10 times. Incubate at room temperature for 5 minutes, followed by exposure to a magnetic field. After 5 minutes, remove and discard the supernatant without disturbing the bead pellet. Wash the beads with freshly prepared 80% ethanol as previously demonstrated. Allow the pellet to dry. Remove the tube or plate containing the dried bead pellet from the magnet and elute the library from the beads by adding 33 microliters of 0.1x TE buffer, followed by mixing well. After a quick spin, incubate at room temperature for 2 minutes. Return the sample to the magnetic field until the sample clears, approximately 5 minutes, and remove 30 microliters of the supernatant containing the library to a new tube. This library can be stored at minus 20 degrees Celsius. You can confirm the size distribution of the library by diluting 1 microliter of the library fivefold with 10 millimolar tris hydrochloride or 0.1x TE buffer and running it on a bioanalyzer using the high sensitivity chip. The final library can be quantitated using qPCR-based methods, such as the NEB-NEXT Library Quant Kit, or using electrophoretic methods like the bioanalyzer. For full details, See the manual for the NEB Next Ultra 2 DNA Library Prep Kit for Illumina, which can be downloaded from our website. For any technical inquiries, please contact NEB Technical Support.